So Insomniac Sony's Spider-Man's Miles Morales is out, and it was fine. To be honest, there isn't a lot to say about this game because you are most likely going to get exactly what you expect out of it. Oh, and I couldn't get my hands on a PS5 in time, so this was reviewed on a PS4. Sorry. So anyway, Spider-Man Miles Morales is kind of a half-sequel to Spider-Man PS4. Consider it Spider-Man 1.5. Taking place right after the first game, we control Miles as he learns how to use his powers and save New York while Peter is on vacation. To start with the stuff that I really liked, I think all the stuff that carries over from the last game still works really well. The web swinging in this game is better than before, and the combat is just as satisfying. Miles can do a lot more tricks while swinging, and his animations are stitched together so nicely. He seamlessly transitions between animations, and I found myself enjoying the swinging in this game way more than I expected. I had a lot of moments where I was just ignoring the missions and just swinging around, which is something I haven't done since Spider-Man 2 back in the day. It just feels like it has been finely tuned. I really enjoyed it. It was already really good in the last game, but now it's just a little bit better. Also, the game still looks really good. I can definitely see myself playing this again on PS5 just to see how it compares. It's also worth noting that a lot of work has gone into making Miles' animations differ from Peter Parker's. He moves like he isn't totally comfortable zipping around, and he's super expressive without needing to say anything. Just watching him in the gameplay makes it apparent that this is not Peter Parker. This is someone who's brand new to being Spider-Man. And as far as the combat goes, I could say it's also just as fun as the first game, but your mileage may vary. Miles has a few differences from Peter in that he doesn't rely on gadgets as much as he does his electric powers. They've kind of taken his bioelectricity way farther than in other iterations of the character, but it's pretty fun to just plow through enemies with his unique abilities. They throw a lot more enemies at you in this game as compared to the first one, since Miles' combat style has a lot more destructive area of effect type abilities. You're honestly going to be plowing through people. There are a lot of enemies in each fight. I think there are like 20 plus enemies in some battles. I played this game on hard, and I had a few fights that were appropriately difficult without being too unfair. Some people have been saying that the combat in this game is more fun than the original game, and some people say that Peter is more fun. Personally, I think that I lean more on the side of Peter being more fun because his gameplay feels a little bit more Spider-Man-y for me, if that makes sense. That isn't to say I didn't like the combat here though, and there are a lot of fun combos and strings that you can pull off that Peter can't even dream of doing. It's just different than the first game, and you have to look at it differently, but as far as I'm concerned, I think it's pretty fun. I was never bored fighting people. It's easy to see footage of this game and think to yourself, well, I think I want to play that game. That looks pretty fun. And honestly, you're not going to be wrong. If this looks fun to you, you're probably going to like the game. This is mostly what you're going to be doing. Now, one concern I do have for this series is that I don't think they know what to do when there isn't a fight or a chase scene. Like in the last game, some missions are just not very fun. There are no more of those weird computer puzzles anymore, but the stuff that they have in this game to replace that is still pretty boring. Sometimes you're like scanning clues to find bad guys, or following pipes through the city, and it's just not fun. This game usually consists of you swinging to a place, watching a cutscene, then fighting guys, then watching another cutscene, then fighting guys, and then maybe doing a dumb puzzle, and then fighting guys again. The fighting and the swinging part is really fun, but it needs to be accompanied by something else that's also fun. When I reviewed the last game, I said that it managed to make boring, mundane shit really fun, but in this one, I think I'm starting to notice the cracks forming. I'm glad that this game removed those Mary Jane levels and any other level where you're not playing as Spider-Man, but it's not like they replaced those levels with anything better. There are some levels in this game that are really cool, and then there are some levels that are pretty forgettable. The characters in this game are also pretty flat, and without Peter around, the script is kind of cringy. I personally think Peter Parker is allowed to be cringy, and when he's around, he can make a corny script a little bit better. But Miles on his own just doesn't grab me in this game. If you ask me, I think he really lacks charisma, and that's pretty disappointing considering how good he is in Spider-Verse. I think making Miles a 17-year-old was a pretty big mistake for this series. Because if he was like 14 or 15, you know, if he was really young like he was when he was introduced in the comics, he would feel way different from Peter just based on his age and what kind of stories we can experience with him. As he stands in this game, he just feels like a boring version of Peter Parker, which is the worst thing Miles can end up as when he's not written properly. Spider-Man really needs to be charismatic. It's really important for making us love him. Another problem I have with this story is the villains. They're pretty lame. And this is always disappointing in superhero games, but in this case, it's especially bothersome because the last game's best levels were the supervillain levels. In this game, I think my favorite parts revolved around chasing or fighting some sort of villain, but those moments are not very common here. And it is slightly undermined by the fact that the villains are kind of underdeveloped as well. It kind of just goes back to the fact that this story didn't really grab me in any way. It's incredibly predictable, and I just wasn't invested in what was happening. I cared a lot more about some of the side quests that I did than the actual main storyline. As the game went on, I kind of found myself having less fun. The opening scene is exciting and action-packed and full of character, and I'd say the game keeps that energy fairly well up until the bridge scene ends. After that, the game decides to lay on the story a lot more, and to be honest, it just wasn't working for me. I'm not gonna spoil anything about the villains or the story, but just know that Miles does not really have the rogues gallery that Peter does. Now, I know it sounds like I'm railing against this game kinda hard, but the thing is that this game isn't bad, it's just not as good as the first game, which I personally fully expected. I kinda treated this game like it was a cute little side story, and I think it does perfectly fine at that. If you're just looking for like an expansion pack for the existing Spider-Man game, then I think this is perfectly fine. It has cool swinging, fun explosive combat, and a forgettable story. So do yourself a favor and do not look at this game as Insomniac's Spider-Man 2, because you're gonna be let down. I think if you played the DLC from the last game and had fun with that, you'll probably enjoy this game just fine. And one thing you should be aware of is that this game is pretty short. If you just brute force your way through the main story, it's like 8 hours. There is of course more stuff to do, and there's things that you can unlock, like a few extra suits or abilities if you put in New Game Plus into the equation as well, but it's up to you if that's worth it or not. I thought the length was fine, but short games don't really bother me unless I really didn't have fun. If you were expecting a game that's as good as the first one, you're probably going to be disappointed, but if you want some more dumb fun, you'll probably get what you're looking for. So if I were to give this game a rating and I wasn't a huge Spider-Man fan, I'd probably give it like a 6, but I am a pretty big fan of Spider-Man and I kind of want to give it a 7, so let's just say it's a 7. Yeah, 7 sounds good. It's a fun game.